presentation line to the podium. And on behalf of the stadium today, so let's please.
Well, what we have noticed is an increase in the participants as compared to the previous mini meets. We saw the inclusion of some of the schools in the previous mini meets. The participation was pretty excellent from the clubs. The performances we have seen in. Improve performances, the kind of performances that we should be seeing. Other persons really have to go back to the drawing board and see, you know, really check their training program, training as for the next few weeks, you know, to get themselves ready for really being the first major event, then following the national games. Well, thus far, what we look at is the performance from last year. What we did is have a pre-selected CARIFTA team. Following that, what we're going to be doing, looking at the performances at the mini-meets and see if we need to add new persons to that pre-selected CARIFTA team. After that, this group of persons would be in training next Saturday at the National Stadium, and they'll be meeting from time to time thereafter. Then at the National Junior Championships, the persons who qualify, who make the qualifying mark for the CARIFTA team, will be selected for the CARIFTA team. But however, if there are persons who performed exceptionally well, or they would have, let's say, meet that the CARIFTA standard at this meet and or the other mini meets, their performance would be considered for selection on the CARIFTA team.
We have the official results. 100 meters. Ladies and gentlemen, they are off. Batch B, 100 meters on the 14 May. The second batch.
Well, the primary meet for selection for CARIFTA in the past and as will continue to happen in the future would be the National Junior Championship this year, and in previous years it would have been the CARIFTA Trials. The idea of selecting from Intercol, it's difficult to consider, and one have to understand it comes down to the timing, because the deadline for the registration of athletes for CARIFTA would have to be taken into consideration, organizing flights and all the logistics that would go into getting the athletes to the CARIFTA games. All of this would have to be taken into consideration. Even coaches have to look at in terms of the events athletes compete at the Intercol games, which would add even pressure on these athletes who would have to compete sometimes a week, sometimes half a week thereafter at the CARIFTA championships. So it's pretty difficult to consider the CARIFTA, the Intercol games, sorry, as selecting in terms of selecting athletes for the CARIFTA games.
400 meters at this stage of the starter. 400 meters at this stage of the starter.
Definitely what you saw is the persons who continue training, the persons who would have been on that year, that full year training from September into, into this part of the year, they are the ones seeing the difference and significant difference in their performance. Whereas the persons who would have fallen on the wayside, persons who kind of became complacent, I can safely say that, you know, they have to look at their decision again, because in some instances it really did not work out for them. Actually, this year we had more meets than last year. It all comes down to, we actually had five planned. We had to call off the one in St. Andrew. So what we have done over the years is try to increase the number of mini meets. But it all comes down to the timing we have in terms of how much we have space on the calendar we have for the year. And it also comes down to the availability of venues. And what we have done is try to bring the mini meets to the outer parishes, St. David, St. Andrews. St. Andrews did not work out this year because of the cricket. But what we have done is try to spread it, try to bring it to the other places, especially where we have track and field, a number of athletes competing. We have tried to increase it, and we're going to see as the calendar next year looks like, because there are many other things that we have to consider when doing our calendar. Karaku is on our long-term development plan. We actually, this year, we would be heading to Karaku to support them in the championship there. We have also have first thing to go to Karaku to do one of our the Right on Track program for the development of the sport in Karaku. We would have done, we're going to be doing some sessions with the officials there prior to their meet. So we have a number of things on card for Karaku, and we're working through one of our affiliates, the Karaku Athletic Committee, and they have been ensuring that the sport stays alive there. So we're working with the Karaku Athletic Committee to ensure that we bring the development to Karaku also.
Athletes,
you
have So it's 100 meters on the 16 day, second batch. The only official result is from the King contestant. Thereof, ladies and gentlemen, 100 meters on the 18A. Three athletes. Look, I think it's going to be the Italian mark from Salt City Rising Stars. But officially. Thereof, ladies and gentlemen, 100 meters, the big ones. Looking for a place, not on the track, the team on the board. But officially, it looks like that lesson.